Holy Spirit, you are welcome And a man that had died and went to heaven, and he went into this library. It was pretty cool. And he said, on the books, he said, there were angels reading our book of things. The scripture talks about our lives are in a book. And he said, as we prayed in the Holy Ghost, we were reading our book. And that God was bringing things to pass. And the more we prayed in the Holy Ghost, and the more that we prayed, the more we were, what was being spoken about our lives would come to pass. And he said there were many things in books that written about people that never came to pass because they didn't pray in the Holy Ghost, that they were actually bringing their books of things to pass. And he said when they were worshiping and they were singing in the Holy Ghost, he said there was golden like glitter all around them. And the angel of the Lord said, or Jesus said to him, breathe in the gold that's around you. Let's take a deep breath and breathe it in. Breathe in God. Because God was trying to teach him how to play a saxophone. He came back from heaven and able to play 7 instruments that he had never played before. 9 instruments. And Jesus taught him how to play the saxophone. I mean, it was just amazingly beautiful. It was amazing. So this morning I got up in prayer and was just praying before the Lord. And I was crying out to the Lord, just crying out to God about our situations, just crying out the heart things. And all of a sudden, I was before the throne of God. This was amazing, y'all. And my face was on the feet of Jesus. And I saw my tears fall on his feet. And when my tears fall on his feet, flowers begin to bloom on the feet of the Lord. And there was like a garden began to form right at the throne, across the feet. It was like this little garden from my tears began to form a garden. And then the flowers from the garden began to turn into a vine and to begin to come up. And the throne was covered with a rainbow hue. You know, it talks about the throne of God and there's a rainbow covering his throne. We need to welcome the Holy Spirit. He's here to bring about our promises. He's here to make things in our book of our lives. He said each one of us have a book and a story of our life before the Lord. And as we prayed in the Holy Spirit, we was reading our own book of our promises so that those words would come to pass. Those words would come to pass. So we want to welcome the Holy Spirit to do his work in us. Just breathe in God's glory. Breathe it in. Holy Spirit, you're welcome here. You're welcome to train me. You're welcome here, Holy Spirit. Jesus. Holy Spirit, you are well in your house. He's welcome. Come to love this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God. thing he said is that you've got to give your will to the Lord. He said, so many of my children will not give me their will. He said, they won't yield to me their will. And if we'll just yield to the will of the Lord, we would receive his will. He said, there's a way that he has that only his will. In this place, we can only move with his will. You got to give up your will. Give up what you want and receive what the Lord is saying. Jesus. Jesus, 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 Jesus. The Lord loves us. He covers us. He said it was Psalm 91 to stay up under those wings. That he that dwelled in the secret place of the Most High. We got to dwell in that secret place. Let your tears build the garden of the Lord.
Hallelujah, the Lord of us.
To be a standard bearer, to hold up the standard bearer for him. truth, Michael, that you are called to be his anointed one that stands up before him and does his will and be that prophetic voice in the earth. What's the truth for Seymour? For him to lead the body, to lead the body in truth. What's the truth for Bonnie? For him to speak, for her to speak the will of the Lord and do the things of God and raise up and be strong and courageous. That's Bonnie's truth. Hallelujah. That she's the Lord's. The spirit of truth would come and lead us and guide us into all truth. That's truth. Jesus, we step today into Jesus' truth of us. Jesus' truth, his truth. His truth. Your truth. I praise you, Lord. I praise you, Lord. I praise. What's Paula's truth? To rise up and to be glorious for the King. To overcome everything. Hallelujah. The Lord is writing in our books. To be a worshiper of the King. To speak his word, his revelatory word. That's Paul's truth before the Lord. Jesus, Jesus. Lord, we want your nudgings. Nudge us, Lord. Nudge us, Lord. Nudge us into your greatness, Lord. To all the things that you've come, O Lord. Let us move quicker, Lord, than before, Lord. To make up for lost time, Lord. Jesus, Jesus, wonderful Jesus. 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 Jesus, Jesus. And you remember how we've been talking to you and preparing you for the move. The Lord showed him the future move. And he said there were three things that was going to stop the move. To advert the move of God. He said number one is the woundedness in the leaders. He said the leaders had holes in them. And if they didn't let the Lord heal them, the glory would come and just leak right out. The Lord showed me a picture of that 20 years ago about cracked pots that could not hold the glory. And that if we didn't get healed from all of the stuff, that if his glory came, it would just leak right out. And the other one was carrying the Ark of the Covenant on a cart, meaning merchandising the move of God. That God did not want his move merchandised. I forgot the third thing, but those are the two things stuck in my heart. So haven't we been preparing a long time, preparing vessels to be moved? And I was laying in bed and I was praying. I woke up, as soon as I woke up, I was praying before the Lord. And I said, Lord, when is your move going to come? And the Lord spoke to me and he said, the move is already here. I was like, what? What, Lord? And he said that the Lord spoke to him. This video was given 2 months ago. And he said the Lord said to him that the move was already here. And it's already here from God's perspective. He said because he's already sent the warring angels are already here. And he said they're in the land and it's already in place. And then when he said that, I was like, oh God, you've already confirmed what you spoke to me, because I heard it just as clear. The still, quiet voice, it was already here. He said the angels and the troops have landed. He said, and they're warring angels, and they're already in the land. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. This is the last call to be healed, to be cleansed, to prepare for the glory, so that you can hold the glory of the Lord. Jesus, let your tears build a garden around the throne's feet. Every tear brings a flower, brings fruit. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus. Again, if you don't have the Holy Spirit, the Lord will lead your mouth to words that will speak your book. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Jesus. Father, fill us up with your glory. Fill us up with your peace, Lord. Fill us up with your rest, oh God. Fill us up, oh God. Fill us up, oh God. And it's up to you to believe and receive it. Just believe. Just believe and receive. Just believe and receive. I believe I receive. I believe I receive all that you have for me.
Thank you, Lord.
Anybody else hearing something from the Lord? We want to hear it.
Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord.
And a blanket of peace. I just sense a blanket of peace about who He is and who you are with Him. And He is bestowing upon you a level of peace that dispels every lie that you have been captive to. The Lord is giving peace to His people.
Amen. You know, so many leaders have been wounded. So many leaders are hurt and broken inside. So many holes inside of us. And when we're hurt, we got holes inside. The Lord showed me this, I think it was 20 or 30 years ago, I saw a pot. And the pot was me and it was cracked. And I saw that every time the Lord poured something in, it was leaking right out. And the leaking was the pain. And the hurt. So many leaders are wounded and hurt in the house of the Lord. And so many sheep are hurt and wounded in the house of the Lord. And if we ask the Lord to heal us and to patch us up, He will take away those wounds. We want vessels that are able to hold the new wine. Saints, the troops are on the ground. The move is here. The Lord said, don't despise a day of small beginnings. And if this move is not like any move that has ever been in the earth. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I love it when He said that when people began to worship, that the angels, He was worshiping, and angels said, come and do that thing that you do that you worship. And the angel said they loved it because when He started worshiping, they would worship with Him. And when He would stop, they would stop. When He would stop, when He would begin, they would begin. So think about it. There's angels in this room worshiping with us. They're worshiping with us. They're glorying us. You see, they see the end from the beginning. They've already won. They see the victory. Hallelujah. They see that we have won.
I think it's already been said, but just about the new wine, that He needs to make us new wine, us to be new wine skins. Because if we're not new, then when He fills us, or wants to fill us, then we're going to burst. Just, we're not going to be able to hold it. So I heard a thing one time, this is kind of on the side, but it says if you have too much word, you'll blow up. If you have too much spirit, you'll just the spirit. If you don't have a word, you'll blow up. If you have just the word, you're going to get puffed up, or you dry up. But if you have both, you can grow up.
Thank you, Lord. I think sometimes when we have too much of the word, we dry up. Thank you, Lord. Without the spirit, because it's the spirit in the word. The letter killeth, but the spirit gives life. And we need the life that's in the word. Otherwise, we're dead and religious. Hallelujah. And we have nothing, but we need the Spirit of the Lord to quicken. God's going to quicken our mortal bodies. There's a quickening coming that's going to quicken us to a new level in Him. Thank you, Lord. And we can't look at the past, forgetting those things are behind, and press on to the mark of the high calling of God. Hallelujah. Too many times we're looking back at what hurt us, and God is saying, forget that stuff. Get healed of it, because there's something glorious coming that far surpassed what has already been. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. So think about when you're in your house and you're praising, there's angels worshiping with you. Hallelujah. They're bringing victory. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we just praise you. You're glorious. You're wonderful. We honor you, Jesus. And we say that you're the King. say that you're the King.
You're the King.
Now hear this word. But the Lord says, I know the plans that I have for you to prosper you and to bring you into a future home. Jeremiah 29:11. I want the Lord's future hope, don't you? Hallelujah. I want the Lord's book that's written about me. Thank you, Lord, to be revealed here in planet Earth. He said that many people's books have not even been opened.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Let's open our books wide. Lord, open them up wide, oh Lord. And let the pages, the words come off the pages, Lord, and write on the volume of our lives, oh God. So saints, be healed in Jesus' name. Every time the pain comes up from our fellow brothers and sisters, be healed in Jesus' name. Drop down in your spirit and forgive. Because the only prisoner is you. And the enemy doesn't take any prisoners. But the Lord sets the captive free. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus. Betty's got one more word. Thank you, Lord.
What a good introduction. Now to Drina, I say, and to all of us, chapter one.
Let's